So for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at adding and subtracting fractions. In our last video, we actually went over simplifying fractions. So if you want to check that video out, I'll leave a link for it down in the description. And I'll also put a card in the top corner. So when we're adding fractions, we want to make sure that the denominators are both the same. So the way we do that is we look at the denominators and we find the lowest common multiple. Then we can find equivalent fractions for each of them with that same denominator. So for this first example, we've got 3 over 8, add 1 over 4. So I take a look at my denominators, I've got 8 and 4. So my lowest common multiple of 8 and 4 is actually 8. So we can turn both these fractions into just 8s. So because our first fraction is already over 8, we can leave it. So we're going to keep 3 over 8 as 3 over 8. But now we want to change this 1/4. So because we've changed it to an 8, we've multiplied the bottom by 2. But to keep this fraction equivalent, I've also got to do that to the top. So because I've times the bottom by 2, I've got to times the top also by 2. So if we do 1 times 2, we get 2. So we've got the fraction 1 over 4 is equal to 2 over 8. So now that these fractions are both over 8, all I have to do now is simply add the numerators. So 3 over 8, add 2 over 8, the denominator is going to stay as 8. We'd now have 5 over 8. And that'd be our answer to that one. We're going to do exactly the same thing for this next question. We've got 1 over 3, add 3 over 4. So we take a look at our denominators, 3 and 4. The lowest common multiple of them is 12. So we're going to turn these two fractions into fractions over 12. And that will give us an answer over 12. So looking at the first fraction, we had 3. Well, we'd have had to multiply the bottom by 4 to make that 12. So to keep things equivalent, we'd have had to do the same to the top. So we've multiplied that by 4. Well, 1 times 4 is 4, so that would be equal to 4 over 12. And then for the 3 over 4, we take a look at that 4 on the bottom. We've multiplied that by 3 to get to 12. So to keep things equivalent, we've also done that to the top. So I'd have had to multiply the 3 by 3, which would have given me 9. So now we've got the denominators the same, all we need to do is add the numerators. So 4 over 12, add 9 over 12, is just 13 over 12. We've got some more questions to have a look at now. Feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for our first question, we've got calculate and simplify. We've got 1 over 6, add 1 over 3. So again, looking at the denominators, we're looking for the lowest common multiple of 6 and 3, which would actually be 6. So we're going to change these fractions into two fractions over 6. Well, the first fraction was already over 6. We had 1 over 6, so that's going to stay as it was. So the 3, to turn that into a 6, we'd have had to multiply the bottom by 2, which means we're also going to do the same to the top. So if we do 1 times 2, we get 2. So now we've got 1 over 6, add 2 over 6 is 3 over 6. The question also said to simplify. So 3 over 6, if we simplify that, we can divide top and bottom by 3. So 3 over 6 is equivalent to 1/2. And that would be in its simplest form. Okay, for our next question, again, calculate and simplify. 1 over 5, add 3 over 4. Again, we look for the lowest common multiple of 5 and 4, which would be 20. So we're going to have two fractions that are over 20 this time. So to make this 5 into a 20, we'd have had to multiply the bottom by 4, which means we're also going to do the same to the top. So if we do 1 multiplied by 4, we get 4. So that would be 4 over 20. And for this fraction on the right, we had 4. We'd have had to multiply that by 5 to make 20, which means we're also going to do the same for the top. So if we do 3 multiplied by 5, we actually get 15. So now we've got 4 over 20, add 15 over 20. That's just going to give us 19 over 20. Okay, for our next example, we've got 5 over 8, add 2 over 3. Again, looking for the lowest common multiple of 8 and 3. That would be 24. So again, we're going to have two fractions that are both over 24 this time. So to turn this 8 into 24, we'd have had to multiply it by 3. So because we've multiplied the bottom by 3, we're going to have to do the same to the top. So if we do 5 times 3, we get 15. So that would be 15 over 24. And then for the 3, we'd have had to multiply that by 8 to make 24, which means we're going to do exactly the same for the top. So if we do 8 times 2, we get 16. So now we've got 15 over 24, add 16 over 24. That's going to give us 31 over 24. And for our last question here, we've got 7 over 10, add 4 over 9. Our lowest common multiple of both of those would be 90. So again, 2 fractions over 90 this time. So we'd have had to multiply the 10 by 9 to make turn that into 90, which means I'm going to multiply the top also by 9. So if I do 7 times 9, we get 63. Then for the 9 here, we'd have had to multiply that by 10 to turn it into 90, which means we're going to do the same for the top also. So if I do 4 times 10, I get 40. So now adding these together, we've got 63 over 90, add 40 over 90, that's going to give us 103 over 90. So well done if you followed along with those. We're going to take a look at some examples now where we're subtracting fractions. So subtracting fractions works very much the same way. We have to make the denominators the same, then we can subtract the numerators. So for this first example, we've got 1 over 3, take away 1 over 4. So again, we need a common denominator. So the way we do that, just like when we did addition, was find the lowest common multiple. So the lowest common multiple of 3 and 4 is actually 12. So we're going to turn these two fractions into fractions over 12. So looking at this first example, I would have had to multiply the 3 by 4 to turn that into 12. So to keep things equivalent, I'm also going to do that to the top. So if we do 1 times 4, we get 4. And then for the 1 over 4, we'd have had to multiply the bottom by 3 to turn that into 12, which means we're going to multiply the top also by 3. So we've got 1 times 3, which would be 3. So now we've got our 2 fractions over 12, so we can subtract the numerators. So 4 over 12, take away 3 over 12, is going to leave us with 1 over 12. Okay, we've got a few more examples to finish off with. Feel free again to pause the video here if you want to have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for our first example, we've got 2 over 3 take away 1 over 4. So again, looking for the lowest common multiple of 3 and 4, that would be 12. So we want two fractions that are both over 12. So to get 12 on the bottom here, we'd have had to multiply by 4. So because we've done that on the bottom, we're going to do it to the top. So we've got 2 multiplied by 4, that'd give us 8. Then on the right hand side, we had 4, we'd have had to have multiplied that by 3 to get 12, which means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So if we do 1 times 3, we get 3. So now we're left with 8 over 12, take away 3 over 12. So our final answer would just be 5 over 12. Okay, for our next example, we've got 7 over 9 take away 13 over 27. So again, the lowest common multiple of 9 and 27 is actually 27. So we want two fractions over 27 this time. So for this first fraction, we'd have had to have multiplied the 9 by 3 to get 27. So that means we're going to do the same to the top to keep it equivalent. So 7 times 3 is actually 21. And then the fraction on the right was already over 27, so we can keep that one as 13 over 27. So all we need to do now is subtract the numerators. So we've got 21, take away 13, which leaves us with 8. So our final answer there would be 8 over 27. Okay, for this next example, we've got 2 over 4, take away 2 over 7. So again, our lowest common multiple of 4 and 7 would actually be 28. So we're going to have two fractions over 28 for this one. So to get 28 on the bottom here, I'd have had to have multiplied that 4 by 7. Which means I'm also going to multiply the top by 7. So if we do 2 times 7, we get 14. So that would be 14 over 28. And then on the right hand side, we've had to have multiplied that 7 by 4, which means we also multiply the top by 4. So if we do 2 times 4, we get 8. So subtracting these now, we've got 14 over 28, take away 8 over 28. That's going to leave us with 6 over 28. But again, the question did say to simplify as well. So what I can do now is look for something to divide top and bottom by. I can divide these both by 2. So if I divide the top by 2, I get 3. Dividing the bottom by 2, I get 14. I can't simplify that any further, so our final answer to this one would be 3 over 14. And for this last example, we've got 9 over 15, take away a half. So again, we're looking for the lowest common multiple of 15 and 2, which is 30. So I'm going to have two fractions over 30 this time. So to get 30, we'd have to multiply the 15 by 2, which means we're also going to multiply the 9 by 2, which would give us 18. And then on the right-hand side, we would have to have multiplied the 2 by 15, which means we're also going to multiply the top by 15 as well. So if we do 1 times 15, we get 15. So subtracting those now, we've got 18 over 30, take away 15 over 30. That's going to leave us with 3 over 30. And then because the question says to simplify, we can simplify that 3 over 30. We can divide top and bottom by 3. That would simplify to 1 over 10. And that would be our final answer for that one. So well done if you followed along with those. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.